Talk365TV's Talking Wellness is brought to you by Brain Rehab Clinic with wellness team expert Dr. John Hatch.
Hey everybody, welcome to another Talking Wellness. Today we are back at Brain Rehab Clinic to continue our coverage on brain function with Dr. John Hatch. Hi.
Hi.
How are you today?
I'm doing really good, thank you.
Thank you so much for having us, because we are talking about a topic today that is near and dear to my heart, concussion. We're going back to basics with the brain, because it is a very common problem and there is some new findings that is a game changer for how you treat concussions, how people should be seeking treatment, all of that good stuff. So let's just dive in. Like, what constitutes a concussion for somebody?
Well, a lot of times we look at mild traumatic brain injury versus traumatic brain injury, and that's just based on the time. If symptoms of post-concussion syndrome last longer than 3 months, they call it a traumatic brain injury. But if it's less than 3 months, then they chalk it up as something as a mild traumatic brain injury. And a lot of these mild traumatic brain injuries, people just go untreated and think nothing of it.
And symptoms, what is a typical symptom versus that isn't noticed as much?
Well, mostly is, again, like sensitivity to light, irritation, fatigue with reading, a lot of gut disturbances. These are things that are associated with traumatic brain injury, but aren't always on the normal scale. Like, scale is you have dizziness, you have vertigo, you have sensitivity to light, sound, headaches. Mm-hmm. That's like your typical, you know,
right,
traumatic
after
brain injury.
You hit your head or you've been
in an
accident.
When that all goes away, and then all of a sudden you start developing gut issues, and you start developing food sensitivities, or you start developing emotional imbalances, they now want to be isolated. They want to be alone. They don't like the same hobbies that they once had. That can be also post-head trauma findings.
It is such a fascinating thing. I think so many people out there have let something slide, and like you're saying, they didn't pay attention. And it's such a huge repercussion when you're talking about the emotional side. Let's talk about how you share patients a bit with a lot of the leaders, including our own Dennis Parker from our wellness team.
Yeah, I have a lot of therapists that once they hit a sticking point in their ability that this patient isn't progressing or they're stuck, they'll refer them here because they know we're going to look at it from a brain standpoint. What's missing? What's not working? A structural problem has a structural solution. And if you can rehab the brain's functionality, again, the newest consensus on all traumatic brain injuries along all medical breakdown is we damage an area of the frontal lobe that deals with the positivity area of the brain, the reward, the happy center. And so if that's not working, all of a sudden you'll see these kids go from really excited about life to just lost everything.
Yeah.
And we touch it to child must be using drugs or must be self-medicating or must be addicted to something, when in reality, they might just be suffering a post-traumatic brain injury and have thought nothing of it, because even the symptoms they've had, they thought it was just normal. And some people think, as soon as I'm back to no symptoms, I'm gonna be just fine. And that's not what we're seeing 6 months, 9 months down the road with these post-traumatic brain injuries.
And then multiple falls, multiple, because this can last up to 30, 40 years post hitting your head your first time, and then maybe you have had secondary, third time. How much does that play in?
That's a great question. I think the more you have repetitive head traumas, the more the brain has to adapt. And that's what I've come to a knowledge over the last couple years, is just to realize that there are people that come in here and they always say, was it this my head trauma? And before I would say, hey, this finding specific is due to a head trauma. But in reality, we might not know that. What we do know is that this area of the brain isn't working. And so whether that was already problematic, then the traumatic brain injury didn't allow the brain to adapt, creating a host of problems down the road, or was it the head trauma that damaged that area? I really couldn't tell you, and no one can, but can we change it? The answer is yes. And that's what's so exciting about being in this field of neuroplasticians, is the ability to change the brain with not worrying what was the initial cause. Was it the time they slipped and hit their tailbone and broke their tailbone and did just a whiplash with no head hit? Or was it the time that their frontal lobe and their actual head hit the car window from a really bad car accident? The real answer is, can you find it? Can you repair it? And then once you repair it, do we expect the outcomes then to change? And that's when I see, referring back to the therapists and the clinicians that are talking people through their traumas and through their emotions, and they get such a greater outcome because they've rehabbed the brain.
So you are a licensed chiropractor, but you're not in here working on backs and hips and knees and all of that. You are a functional neurologist chiropractor. Mm-hmm. Explain your specialty there, because that took some time and some years. And tell me how that went into treating traumatic brain injuries.
Yeah, it's funny that you ask, because I get this a lot. A lot of times people are coming in here and they don't even know I'm a chiropractor, even though that's my license. But what I do is, Norman Deutsch coined this phrase, a neuroplastician. And a neuroplastician is someone who looks at the brain and tries to change its functionality and improve the outcome that someone might be dealing with, like a post-stroke victim that doesn't have use of the left arm. Mm-hmm. If you can rehab the aspects of the brain and get that arm to move or make things change with a broken system, that's what they're calling neuroplastician. And so what we try to do is we use all the diagnostic tools to tell us what part of the brain's not working, mm-hmm. and then once we understand that, we know how to rehab it. And whether that be through light therapy or neurofeedback or biofeedback, whatever the modality is, it really doesn't matter what discipline of medicine you might be in, as long as you're trying to improve brain function and change how a brain is working, mm-hmm. then that's where that coin phrase of neuroplastician. So yes, by license, I'm a chiropractor. I love rehabbing brains, and so my passion and desire has gone strictly to how can I improve someone's function.
Well, and you are a leader in your industry. You are recognized and acknowledged both by your peers and not only here locally, but nationally and internationally. You have people coming from all over the world because of your diagnostic ability. Your ability to get those test results and then to be able to come up with a plan is unmatched. And then beyond your special skills, you have the equipment here, like the gyro stem, and then you go through a series of exercises. Let's talk about what happens when they come in.
Yeah, so once they come in and we run the different diagnostics and we create a plan, we like to be in a week intense so that we know, are we changing this brain or are we not? Mm-hmm. And then there's continual at-home exercises to make the brain change. It's not like a one-size-fits-all. It's not a one-and-done event week and we're done. It's like consistency is the key to change.
Well, and every single treatment plan you put together is customized for that brain, for that specific problem, and then you test your own plan week after week, day after day. So post-testing, let's talk about the importance of that.
Well, it's one thing to talk the big talk. It's another thing to, you know, proof's in the pudding. Mm. As you diagnose and come up with, oh, okay, this area of the brain isn't changing, well, let's do a post-check and see, did we actually change it? And I think that's what's been so fascinating for me is not only seeing the symptoms change in a person's life, but actually seeing that the brain is plastic, it can change, and seeing a brain 3 months, 6 months, 9 months down the road, and say they get another head trauma, and I review their exams, and every test is normal, then we know that brain can truly handle it. Because there are a lot of people that get head traumas that have no side effect and no symptom, and they go, I've had like 13 head traumas and I'm okay. They might be okay because the brain can adapt. Mm. Some brains can't. Mm. And that's what I worry about the most, is how many people are on this planet suffering because they have a hidden head trauma that they just think is just the way they are. Right. They don't have to be that way. They don't have to suffer. And that's why, to me, it's worth coming here to see a change that can make a life-changing experience for your family, for your relationships, for your just own personal confidence.
You truly have been able to help people who have been multiple places before and really, even in this line of help, had a hard time finding what they needed. And suicidality and anxiety, depression, I mean, all of those things are such heavy, heavy issues that plague our society right now. And those are all things that are alleviated when you do have trauma to those centers. And if you've exhausted your resources with medication, with diet, with the therapist, all of those things are not working. That is where what you do is something that I always feel so great about, telling people to just get in here, because what do you have to lose? Either testing will say, yeah, something happened, or it won't.
Mm-hmm. And as you talked about the topic of suicide and anxiety and depression, we've seen so many cases that have had severe attempts at suicide, and we see where the breakdown is in their brain and get it to change. I mean, there's a lot of OCD and breakdowns in reward systems and hyperfixations. There's so much to the brain that people didn't understand, and we're still learning it. Mm-hmm. I've learned more in the last 3 months than I learned 3 years. Mm-hmm. And it's so exciting to see what we can do and how more specific we can get in therapy and treatment. and know that we're going to have an outcome that can save this person's life. Huge. That matters to me.
So if you want more information, log on to the website. We have many online consultations or online trainings. There's all kinds of information. If you would like more of it, learning more about Dr. Hatch, more about the facility, log into the website. You can purchase one of those. Mm-hmm. And that way it speeds up the whole process for you, because pretty much you get that first consultation, all those questions out of the way. And then when you get into here, you can really just focus on your results, your testing. So it's a great way to go. We welcome you to check that out, or just give them a call, set up an appointment, get your testing done, because at the end of the day, it's the proof is in the pudding. Mm-hmm. We will know mm-hmm. what to do when you look at those tests.
Absolutely.
Dr. Hatch, thank you for your time.
Thank you so very much.
Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back on Talk365 TV right after this.